Hi, welcome back to my channel. Today I thought I would do a bit more thorough flip through of Bruce's Pet Health Weekly Supplement Planner. And it's something that I use to keep track of his health, his pooping schedule, his medication, anything that I need to share with my vet, I have right here. This is what I take with me every time we go to his vet or to his cardiologist. So a quick background on Bruce. Bruce is an English Bulldog. We adopted him in 2018. They found him on the streets with a really bad case of mange. We took him to our vet. The vet discovered that he had a heart murmur. He could hear it. Second opinion, they could hear it. We took him to our cardiologist to try and to figure out how bad the heart murmur was. We discovered that it was a bad heart murmur. I think they said it was a grade 5. It is not fixable. And because he's an English Bulldog, they don't recommend fixing it because of his short nose. You know, his snout is very short. It's almost, well, it's not flat against his face, but he doesn't have a long nose. Think of a German Shepherd or like a Golden Retriever. Having said all that, this is something that I take with me when we see the vet or his cardiologist. And I've been using the weekly supplement, the A6 Hobonichi. With the daily pages is just too much. This is just perfect for me. So this is the first week of January. This is the weekly look. This is what a blank week looks like. Bruce gets his flea medication on the first of the month. So that's the sticker up here. I do keep track of his poop and when he drinks water, because Bruce does not drink a whole lot of water throughout the day. He drinks a lot at a time that he chooses, the times that I mark. Because I just thought it was like on Tuesday, on the 2nd, he only drank water one time and was fine the rest of the day. But on Monday, he drank 4 times, which I thought was really interesting. His pooping schedule, again, is up here. So every time he goes to the bathroom, I basically have 4 squares. Do I have a blank one to show you? Okay, so this is for this week. So I do 4 squares. So this is basically morning, AM, like 5 in the morning, which is when we get up. This would be like, say, if he went to the bathroom like at 10. And then the marker would be noon. So if he went at 2 o'clock, that would be this square. And this would be at in the evening. So like if he went at 9 o'clock. So that's how I, that's why there's 4 squares up there. That's how I sort of break it down. Going back to here. So I mark down when he poops, when he drinks water. And because Bruce is having problems with his ears, and eventually you'll see down here on Saturday with his eyes, this is how I keep track. On the 6th, we had an appointment with his vet to check out his ears. So up until this point last year, at the end of December, the vet prescribed ear medication for him. We had to give it to him twice a day. And so this is where, I forgot to mark these. This is where we were giving it to him. And so I would check it off. And then up here is, you can see, like I wrote D10, D11. So those were the days, because this particular medication I was supposed to give to him for 14 days. And then after we saw the vet, she started him on new medication for his ears. Here's day 1, day 2. And then we started, it's an eye drop. And so I started it here. And she said to give it as needed. And so every time I gave it to him, I did a little square and then I checked it off. So you can see on the 6th, I gave it to him one time because we saw the vet at 11 a.m. And so I decided to wait a couple of hours before giving it to him. And then here, I gave it to him 3 times. And then in addition to the eye drops, he also has eye ointment that we give him. And that one I don't keep track of because we always give it to him in the morning and at night. That's routine. That's something that he gets every single day. With this ear medication, we have him, actually it's an ear ointment. She said 7 days. So today will be the 7th day. I did give it to him this morning, so I need to check that out. He did go to the bathroom, so I need to mark that. This is Friday morning, which is why this is not filled in yet. And then here we are. So this is the
sweet. Because his eyes were gunky,
I started seeing less of it up here. So this is where I would write it up here. And then when we see the vet, I think we're going on the 22nd. Do I have a sticker down for that? I don't. Now back here. Yeah, back here, this is the Hobonichi blank notebook, A6 size. And I've been using this as his pet history. So this is all the medication that Bruce is taking. So I have this on the Hobonichi paper. That's what this looks like. Here's a couple of more medication with some instructions that I wrote down when she was talking. I was taking notes. So that's this. And then this is an extra sheet. This is, I've been keeping track of Bruce's weight. I've been trying to keep him, because of his heart, I can't let him get heavy. And so I've been trying to keep him like in the 50-ish range. And so you can see like right now he's at 53 pounds, which I think is pretty good. The vet is happy with that. At one point last year, so in April, he was 55 pounds. The heavier he is, the harder his heart's gonna work. That's why I've been trying to get it down just a little bit. Here is when we first adopted him. What? So it was October 8th. Was actually our first visit. We adopted Bruce October 6th, which is also the anniversary with myself and my husband. So every time we had a visit with anybody, I would mark it down here. So you can see we had an appointment on the 8th, the 13th. On April 13, 2019, we had a recheck with the cardiologist. See how I've been sort of keeping, so this is like a diary style. Here we are current. I decided to be a bit more specific. On January 6, 2024, he had an eye recheck. He had his nails trimmed. And then because we have him on eye ointment, I decided to write down the medication and then the instructions that they gave us. So for this one, Optimmune, he's taking it 2 times a day. And then he has his refresh at least twice a day. Redness in his ear that I've been putting ointment on. So this is the name of the ointment. This is the size of the little bottle. And then the instructions right here. So I have to give it to him every 12 hours for 7 days. I think this helps having something so detailed like this, so that when you see your vet, you can say, okay, yeah, you know what? I saw you on the 6th. This is what we did. This is the medication that he's on, Bruce. And this is how many times you told us to do. I just like taking this with me. I like keeping track. And that way, if the vet or his cardiologist has any questions, I can pull this guy out. And if they ask me questions about his dog food, which I wrote, did I get rid of it? Nope, it's right there. So Bruce eats neutral chicken and brown rice, because they always seem to ask me that every time we go visit. They always ask what he eats, what he's on, medication, stuff like that, how he's been feeling. Has he been pooping normally? Has he been drinking water? All these questions, I have them in here. So that way, at a glance, I can tell them if he's normal or not normal. So I hope this helps you if you want to start a pet health tracker planner for your pets. I just think it's really handy to have. And gives you a little peace of mind so that if they ask you a question, that you'll have an answer for it. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you like to see after the pin videos of my Hobonichi, generally of my cousin. Have a good weekend, and I'll see you around. Bye!